Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Dipen from Pune. I'm back with my Dominar. I'm going to be doing some maintenance today. I recently got the bike serviced, but I'd not done the oil change there. I did the oil change at home, and I did do a video on the oil change too. If you guys have missed that, I'll leave the link to the oil change in the description. Please do have a look at that. So while doing the oil change, I noticed that the belly was completely filled with oil. Okay, so that means during the service all these parts were left out, and again that clicked me that, you know, the radiator might be dirty too. So I removed the radiator cover just now and I saw that the complete radiator is filled with the mud, muck, slush, whatever you want to call it. So why am I doing this video? Mainly to show you guys, you know, how you can clean your radiator. If it is clogged like this or dirty like this, it might affect cooling slightly. So that's the main reason I'm doing this video. I'll be showing you the complete radiator, how bad it is before I do the wash, and how good it is after I do the wash. I'll show you what all tools and what material I use to clean, so that'll be a bit helpful to you guys also. At the end of the video, I'll also add clippings of the service that I had done. The paid service that I did, and what all, you know, the how dirty the air filter was or how dirty the front sprocket section was. I'm not going to be opening the front sprocket right now because that was cleaned in front of me at the service station and that is pretty clean now. So this part I'm just going to be covering the main radiator and showing it to you guys. I'll be doing the complete wash, but I'll not show you that part. It's the main part that I'm going to be showing it to you guys. So do wash till the end. So this is the condition of the radiator. Okay. Let me turn on the flash if it makes a difference. No, it does not. But yeah, you can see the top corners and all, it looks quite dirty. So I've already taken the cover off, the plastic cover that comes on the radiator. So I would advise every one of you to, you know, at least get this cleaned once in 6 months, or especially after rains, so that any such dirt or, you know, uncleaned part is there on the radiator, it goes off the bike and it doesn't affect the cooling. So it is very simple to remove the cover. I've already done it, so I'm not able to show you. You need to remove these two bolts, Allen bolts. Once you've done that, remove the two top nuts. Okay, two bolts first here, two top nuts here. Okay, remove those. Once these four nuts and bolts are removed, the plastic grill will be about free. Then you have press clips over here, button press ones. So you insert a screwdriver and press that part, and press all four, and then remove the clips, and the radiator would be, the cover would be off. If possible, you know, while fixing the bat or something, I'll try and show you guys how to remove the cover. But for now, I'm going to be start with the cleaning process of the radiator. I'm going to be using a regular toothbrush, okay, that I use to clean the bike. It's going to be more than enough. I've got a diesel that I'm going to be using because I'm sure the mud, muck, etc. is, the slush is not going to, or the deposits, the mud deposits are not going to come off with the plain soap, because this must be quite long that these have been, the deposits have been on the radiator, and they must have been heated and cooled and cooled and again heated and so on, and, you know, must be quite rigidly fixed over there. So I'll be doing a time lapse video. I will not do a regular video. So let's begin. Give you guys a
tip before doing this, make sure your radiator is completely cooled. It should not be hot, okay? It should be in cold condition. And before, you know, some guys, you might say that diesel is very harmful to the bike. No, I've been using diesel for years now, almost since 1996. And no, diesel will not harm the bike. It will not erode the color. It will not ignite too, because diesel requires compression to ignite. But I've given you a tip. Make sure the radiator is absolutely cold. And while doing the wash, while doing a water wash on this, make sure you're not applying pressure. Normal tap water pressure is more than enough. So I'll speak and give you more tips and show you guys ahead once I proceed. I'll start with giving a water wash now to the radiator. Now remember, even while cleaning, I've used as soft bristle brush as I could. Do not apply pressure on the radiator. The fins are very, 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 very delicate. They would bend, and that would in turn affect more of the cooling of the bike. Even now I'm not using any pressure wash, it's just the tap water pressure that I'm using. I'll do this pressure wash twice or thrice so that the diesel is removed completely. Now there are fins that will be dirty on the backside too of the radiator. I cannot reach that. For that you need to remove the complete radiator. So I won't be doing that part. For now we'll just be cleaning the radiator from the front. Again repeating, do not apply pressure, do not give pressure wash. Even when you're going in the going outside to do a pressure wash, make sure you ask the guy not to apply complete pressure on the radiator. The fin should not bend at all. Okay. Make sure you put water from the front side so that the diesel is removed completely. Now I'll wait for some time and then again do a water wash. Sorry, I can't take my tripod very close. So next what I'm going to be doing is I've prepared a soap water solution. Okay, I'm going to be applying this soap water solution twice or thrice on the radiator to remove any remaining diesel deposits or, you know, any dirt or slush left out in the bike. So soap solution, the quantity of soap is more in this solution than regular, and the soap is one of the soaps that are used for bike or car wash. You can use those two. Any good soap that you have, you can use, that you regularly use for bike wash. Now make sure you wash twice or thrice with the soap so that all diesel truly comes out. That's pretty much from my side for cleaning the radiator, taking great care of the radiator so that it cools quite, you know, optimistically, you know, works very well. So after this clip, I'll be adding one clip for the air filter that was removed from my bike after usage of approximately 4000 or 5000, I don't recollect. So there'll be one clip for that, and there'll be another clip for a small clip where, you know, I've shown how dirty the front sprocket was. So, and after that I'll be adding some pics for this radiator that I've cleaned. That is, after the bike dries out, I'll take some photographs and clips and add that too. So do watch it till the end. And if you guys have any questions regarding this work or comments, or if you've done some cleaned the radiator in some other manner, please do let me know. Add it in the comments. That will be useful for me and others who are come on my video. They'll be able to also follow that. So thanks for watching. This is Dipen from Pune. So this is the condition of my bike's air filter. Bike has done almost like 5 or 6,000 kilometers after, you know, the last service. You can see it is completely clogged. So this is what I, the green part is what I cleaned with. This is what I've cleaned off. What you can't see. So there's a lot of, you know, burr on it. This gets created with, you know, fog in the environment or dusty environment, and then deposits that come out on the air filter. So this is the intake side and this is the outside type side, the inside where the air gets sucked in from, and this is what gets damaged the most. So it is advised to, you know, get the air filter checked and changed every 4,000 to 5,000 kilometers. It will be good for vehicles' heart. This is the amount of dirt, you know, and debris and all extra oil and lube that is present in the front sprocket.